this tie a standard done without a trailing shuck? And for demonstration purposes, I'll get a bigger hackle. That was just a little bit too small. So for tails for these flies, I normally use wood duck. So I'll just take a wood duck flank feather, preen the fibers back, and cut this tip out. And then I can slice these off like bologna and make additional tails. Actually, I'm going to get my rib for pinks. This is a YLI silk thread. You have to buy it online through a sewing shop. That color happens to be pinky brown, and it happens to work really well. It just seems to be a good color for pinks. So I'm going to tie this on the bottom. Because when I rib the fly, I can put it underneath the tail and elevate it. This under, and I'll just draw this tight, and I'll elevate my tail and rib it. Thank you. That's a little better than the first one. That's a good question.
Depends on the fit.
I don't know. I guided on the Snake in below Palisades for 30 years, and the pink hackle stacker came on the scene, and it seemed to be a real popular fly. And I really didn't even know how to do it. I mean, I never heard of such a thing, didn't know how to do it. Started investigating and found out how to do it. And to be honest with you, I don't know that it is more effective. But it's I think it's a really cool process. I mean, I think whoever invented this had a lot of good thought. What I like to do, though, is if I'm making divided wings, divided wing flies, is to divide the wings and then pull a paraloop through the wings. So it's a different look than a parachute, and they're really pretty slick.